Fascinatingly, in this parasha is the calendar of the Jewish people. The very first mitzvah, HaChodesh Hazeh Lachem Rosh Chodashim. This month shall be for you the first of the months. Why is this the first of the months? That's the month of Nisan. Why is it the first of the months? Because it is with the beginning of the new year. And the mitzvah is HaChodesh Hazeh Lachem Rosh Chodashim. This shall be for you the beginning of the months. Aren't there other important months that perhaps should be the first of the months? Why is it Tafka, the month that the Jews came out of slavery? And built into this question is a second question. Why did God create human beings? And especially human beings who are basically imperfect with the Yetzer Tov and the Yetzer Hara. They can do wonderful things, but they can do horrific things at the same time. Why didn't he create human beings without the ability to destroy? I think the answer is a very important one. The real name of God is Yud-Kei-Vav-Kei, verb to be. I will be, as we explained it last week, but more profound than that. I am the God who allows humanity to truly be free and to be in control of time. What he does with his time and how he spends his time, which is the essence of freedom. Most people feel completely stymied by time. Tomorrow and tomorrow and tomorrow beats on this petty pace to the last syllable of recorded time. They see time as being cyclical. They see time as controlling them, and they can't control time. Life is a tale told by an idiot, signifying nothing, full of sound and fury. That's what a secular poet said. Because we're sort of locked into time. God said, I'm a God of love. And the most important gift that I can give to the people whom I have created, because I love humans, the greatest gift that I can give to them is the possibility of controlling the time that is within their orbit to control. No one knows how long he's going to live. But what he does during the time that he is living is up to him. And the most important question that most people ask, if they're serious, what shall I do with my time? The answer the Torah gives is, make use of your time to help yourself and to help others to make the world a better world. And God says it's not only up to me, as I explained last week. HaChodesh HaZeh Lachem Rosh Chodeshim, that's this week. Don't think that time is cyclically above you and you are in effect within the grips of time and can't control it. No. You can overcome evil, even evil instinct. You have the power to do it, but you have to use the time to do it. You can help people by simply smiling at them and giving them a good word. It's up to you. And you can make great inventions, great discoveries, and bring light where there is darkness in many different ways by using your time responsibly. The first mitzvah is HaChodesh HaZeh Lachem. Don't think that you are in the grips of a time that you can't control. You control every minute that you live. That's why God had to make us free. Not only free from Egyptians, but free from the evil instincts that everyone has. Opposite the good instinct. We must nourish the good instinct and try to kill the bad instinct. We have to use our time to become better people and to do better things. That's why the first mitzvah is understanding that you don't know how long you're going to live, but you can determine how you are going to live the next few days, weeks, months, and sometimes years. That's our job. HaChodesh HaZeh Lachem. God wants to bring redemption, but we have to help him. And we have to do it first. Anyone who believes you have to wait for the Messiah to bring redemption doesn't know what he's talking about. The Messiah is waiting for you, for us. And that we see in modern history today. We waited for 2,000 years and nothing happened. The Zionist movement in the 19th century made us return to Eretz Yisrael. The Messiah waited for us. Thank God we moved, at least some of us. God bless you all.